Okay, so for Katarina mid, I'm going to be going Magic Pen Reds, Armor Yellows, MR Blues, 1 AP Quint, and 2 Health Regen Quints. And my Masteries are going to be Exposed Weakness, 21 in the Defensive Tree, I believe. Let me see what's their team again. Have AV damage, so this point's not that great.
Oh, he's got second win.
Legendary Guardian. Should be fine. Actually, what the heck? I guess that's okay. Nine 21-0. Just focus on getting tanky. I'm gonna take Ignite because I'm Mercenary and Alistar, so I wanna be able to kill them. And through their healing. And then yeah, just 921. I got the AP points and I put 21 defense. Pretty standard defensive setup. Not standard on Katarina, but as you guys might know, always have liked playing Katarina for more of a defensive spec because to me, if you can survive longer in team fights, get the assist proc on everyone and then look for the reset, then you can do you can be more effective than if you are doing a bit more damage. But there's trade-offs. It's not to say that I never go like 21 offense on Katarina, because I do, but I just sometimes decide to pick up defensive tree, and it's usually just when I have a feel for it based on the game. Like this, the team I'm playing against is fairly tanky. A lot of auto attack based champions. I just think the defensive tree is going to be more effective. That's why I go for it. RG based off feel, to be honest. Time to go in. Hi guys, what's up and welcome back to the stream. I'm playing Katarina mid. I think I'm either against Nidalee or Alistar mid. I'm not sure who it is yet. I'll find out shortly. It's Nidalee. Okay, that's fine. Start Duron's shield and one health pot. That's going to give me enough sustain to lane pretty comfortably versus Nidalee. And if she tries to abuse her auto attacks to try to wither me down, I have the Duron's shield and the defensive mastery set up to help protect against that. And what did she start with? Was it trap? Yep, it was trap. So she's just placing those traps on the wave, trying to push it out. They have Aatrox jungle. I'm just going to keep Q spamming her for the harass. It's not going to add up too much at level 1. But it's just to show her that I don't want to be bullied around. I mean business. And I'm going to take my E. Aatrox is going to be his red, that's fine. I have a trinket and I'm not afraid of him at all. I can just jump away if he comes to gank me. And if he ganks me, then he's not going to be ganking my teammates. So I'm actually going to be trying to draw out his pressure if I can. Almost level 3. Pretty much keeping up even CS, which is all I want to do when I play Katarina. I just want to free farm the early game if I can. Usually, the enemy champion I'm laying against is going to put more pressure on me, and they're going to make that difficult to do. But someone like Nidalee doesn't really have that much early pressure, especially when I start Duron's shield, so it's not going to be too easy for her to, like, apply pressure in the same way as somebody like Ziggs or Syndra or Orianna would be able to do. As you can see, I'm a little bit chunked, but it's nothing that's gonna like gravely concern me. Pretty much got all of those. Gotta be careful not to get hit by random spears, and I should be able to keep my health up here. If you master how to CS with Katarina on her turret, then you will be very happy with yourself. Oh, I missed one. W just came up a little too late. I had to burn her health pot because she landed that random spear on me. But I'm just comfortably doing my farming thing. The trap fade on the creeps. Outsourcing nearly by 8 right now. Pretty happy with that. Still got my trinket, still got Flash and Ignite up. Poking her with Qs. Just gonna Shumpo her spear so I don't take damage. Shumpo's down for 10 seconds. Gotta be a bit careful during that time window to not get ganked by Aatrox, but I think I should be fine. Thanks, guy. Getting pretty close to level 6. I'm just gonna jump up for that one. Don't wanna miss it. 47 CS to 37. Outsourcing her pretty well, and I'm almost level 6. Nilly's gonna hit 6. She's gonna get probably more out of level 6 than I will. Nilly's level 6 is really her favorite spot to be at, because she gets her young cougar form. And she evolves into something else, but still can fight against her. Alright, let's see here. Well, 13 CS, Aatrox is mid. I think he wanted some help holding, but I would like to keep him in lane as long as possible, just because I have plenty of sustain. Aatrox might be around mid. Gotta be careful. I don't really want to dash onto him aggressively, even though I'm ahead in health and he's low on mana, just because the only way I could really lose my advantage here is if I get ganked by Aatrox and died. He's getting to the point where I'm starting to consider it, though. He's actually like moving towards like relative kill range. You gotta remember that he has barriers, so it's gonna be harder to kill him than standard mid at that level of HP. Fuck, I thought there was creeps there. I could have easily lived, I just... Yeah, whatever, it doesn't matter what I say, I just got confused. Got first blood. Place a flash. I get sword shoes. And... I'm gonna get that health pots. I should have just ward hopped this way. I still had my trinket up and I got the reset and then I could have just walked out. I jumped towards the creeps because I thought that I thought there was still a wave under turret. As there was before I went for the dive. But they all had recently died. Like when I jumped the last creep was dying, so end up just getting myself killed. Still got first blood, so it's still worth it. We traded both summoners, but I outplayed him pretty hard and I just basically messed up. Pretty silly. I flashed this way because I was trying to get in the blind spot to avoid the last turret shot, but it hit me anyway and I just died. That was a relatively accurate count of the events that just occurred. Nilly got blue buff, so she's gonna be able to heal and spear and trap to her heart's content. I'm just chilling here with what I got. Try not to take too much free damage. Yes. God, I feel so dumb. I went Seekers because I had just enough gold for it. I could have also gone for like Ruby Crystal and Amptome. He worked towards the Haunting guys out and perfectly fine too. Zhonya's is going to be a pretty good pickup for me this game. It's not amazing personally because she doesn't really rely on armor at all to deal damage to me. So the actual armor that I'm getting is wasted. It's not exactly like the most efficient pickup I could have got for lane, but I'm just sort of working towards my Zhonya's and I'm okay with itemizing a little bit inefficiently for lane, especially because I'm already winning my lane. Yeah, I have no flash now, and Nilly got a kill that she really didn't need to get, so can't really take advantage of my lead that I should have had as well as I could have. I saw it's a little too late. Good use of the blind spot. Just went for it while I was focused on going for the CS. Her blue is going to be out fairly soon. The thing about that kill was that I played it really well because I didn't have to use flash to get that last E off. I just made sure to stay just at the tip and get in range to kill her. But I just derped and lost what I had built up at that point when I suicided to turret. Still out CSing my 20. Definitely winning this lane. Pretty hard in my book. Katarina is not that great for most things, but she can definitely pressure when given the opportunity to do so, and that's what I was doing. I just kind of out-sustained him, kept him in lane, canceled his recall and tried to go back, and he stayed. He was greedy. Just went for the dive. I baited out his pounce, and just went for the kill after that. Blue just faded, that means no more infinite mana regen and spears, which is good. Trap's gonna get taken by something. Trax is behind me. Should be fine, he just pillaged. Fine. Head back mid, hopefully this isn't warded. I had my E up, I just didn't get it off before he got his Q off. That's still good for us, 2-for-1, but I should have been able to get the double kill. I think if I spammed E a little faster, I think I was a little late on my E. Cause I got the Q off again, but I didn't manage to get the E in time. I think I should have been able to. I'll take it, but not as clean as it could have been. Just gonna need to see that draw, pots, and a ward, and head back mid. Use both summoners on that, as did Nilly. It was good for our team overall, we got 2-for-1. Just could have been better. I targeted the wrong one, really. Check out all those creeps. I just assumed the turret was going to go on that one, so I outed it. I have Zhonya's now. think I'm gonna buy Sonya. She's probably gonna cancel my recall. Just enough for homework. She probably didn't realize it back. Probably doing a camp or something. Doing dragon. Okay. I'm just coming to top. That's probably why they went for drag. Oh shit. It is a hyphy play. It's probably gonna work because it's Alistar Zoom. They get it? Got it. Just messing with them. And fight this. Get some people in the area. I guess it's not worth it. 3v4. Probably gotta kill top in a turret. They got dragon off it though, but it's whatever. Ow, I walked into that. Going back again. Got hungry. Nilly is coming. Just trying to ping that. They should have won the fight though. Yeah, they did. I get 2 health pots and an amp tom and head mid. What's that Alistar building? Oh, he's building all armor. Okay, it's pretty damn tanky though. 2.2k health. But I should about to outpush him. Yeah, Oval, I should do fine versus Nilly. Oval has all armor too. This might not necessarily be like super profitable for us, but it should be like fine. This one, yes. Push this in. They got 3 kills off that. Not good. I'm in. My life, dude. Nighttick did not finish off Nilly. I needed 1 W or Q on her. Damn, she's so low after healing. I'm gonna recall 5 homewards. Didn't really see an opportune time to use Zhonya's there, better than how I played it. Because if I used it, I would have given them time to converge on me, which I don't think was the best bet. Got Haunting Guys and Zhonya's. No flash or ignite up. Max Q first usually, unless you're versus melee, where W is pretty good. Top lane cat, same thing. Both Q and W are not bad to max, but versus range champions, you almost never get to use W effectively if you max it first. My cooldowns are down, so I was just stalling for time with the Zhonya's. value bidder anyway. Pathing kind of messed up my jump there. Doesn't usually happen. Good job, team. It's on me. It should go on the bear. Not that bear. I meant the tubers. I probably have to stop pushing. They're all up. I'm gonna go farm bot. And pretty close to 1600 gold if I want to get another Neosu Large Rod. I could consider that. It's risky to go for. I'm gonna drag it out and try to kill it. Damn, you had ignite and everything up. This is the dumbest thing I've ever done. Just disrespect. I didn't think you could win. I thought worst case I would be able to like get out somehow, but the ignite pick just finished round. Pretty unnecessary. Not sure why I did it. My bad. Could just farm bot and got like 300 gold off those waves. Instead of like randomly tunneling for the red buff. It was a pretty trolled play. Never actually do that. So do something like that. And I knew going into it was like bad. I don't know. Just having good plays left and right. Just felt like doing something crazy. Alright, let's see. The teams got three melees, pretty tanky. Let's go alt damage. They're gonna get Baron. Oh, that death. That red was so unnecessary. You gotta stop doing stuff like that in solo queue. Like, I knew it was terrible. I just got it. He's dead. Decent cleanup. I think they thought they were like baiting us, but we actually just ended up winning the fight, sweeping the floor with them. Good farm bot. There's three dead, but they're about to come up. I'm pretty damn low. I know these three could finish me off if she's like randomly here. Or she could just hunt me down because she sees my low HP. Probably what I would go for, but I think this guy's probably not doing it. Damn, those waves I bought, no one ever farmed them. Literally, I came here as 4CS. Shit. Wish I had some pots on me. Enough damage. I had ignite tick on me, that's why I suicided with the flash. I thought I was dead either way. Maybe it faded with the Zonya's timer. I don't think it did though. Could have been wrong. I think it wasn't like if I was there earlier, obviously it could have been really. Oh, what is that guy doing? Yeah. Really went in way too ham, but I think Ferris is trapped now. He's in for a rough time. Oh. Get a few health pots, finish my death cap. And the void staff next. I'm just going full damage. Seems pretty easy to get a reset off their team because my team is full tank. If I went Rylai's Leandres, it would have been effective this game too. We would have been pretty much unkillable and I could just peel for like the Varus. I could also deal good damage while not really being threatened, but they don't really have anyone to kill me. Anya's just came up. Just headbutt. Don't want to walk into them. I need other people to lead. He's gonna be careful. We're just about to kill him. Oh my god, the god. Nice snipe. Good team fight, everyone. Go for a mid. Get blasting one off that. And wait, Seth next. Alright, I got a blasting one. Alright, just got level 16. Max rank of my ultimate has been achieved. Goes working on Visage. Yep, he will be an animal at that point. It's gonna be at almost max CDR. No. Chucking cleavers and fuck. I was trying to ask for a jump. Oh my god, I didn't die. God, I almost died. When the Blitz grabbed, I was like, damn, I'm dead. But then they didn't actually do anything off it. Back in here, hopefully they don't see me. I just wanted to go with my team here. I was like, ping, ping, Shumpo. But they weren't paying attention. So the Blitz walked up and grabbed me. I could have just walked around. I was just lazy. Should've just ran. Could've gotten away. Mundo wasn't quite there yet. Could've turned if I had a tank line backing me. I should've just peaced out. I was looking for like the flash Shumpo play onto like the Nilly or something, but it was not meant to be there. Oh, Mundo's going in. Damn. Probably just gonna get knocked out, yep. That's not good. We gotta be careful. We can lose this game. We're going a little too crazy. Like, we were winning the game. We, like, dove the Nexus. And now they keep getting like random advantages. Like we gave them two Barons in a row that we should not have. I'm trying to come to Baron. Probably gonna be late. Last time I said that I got a Steel Gragas, but they're actually like five people there killing it. I don't think I'm gonna do much. 5k, about to die. Oh, if he got the stun off. Oh my god, I could have killed them all. So close. Should have not come in fully to that. Should have saw where Annie was. I could have saw that longer. I could have saw my death longer. If I just jumped in, like on the person here, not right in the middle of four people, then Annie would have made it here in time. She got the stun off. I came out of Zhonya's and probably killed him. Ash, we're throwing pretty hard. Gotta be careful. Nilly's getting late. Lucian's been big, but he's gonna have a Last Whisper now. And the Aatrox, who is like just a blade and the Hexshrinker, is now actually getting tank items, so he's gonna be harder to kill. And their Alistar and their Blitz are both getting respectively big. Very hard to burst down, and they got a lot of CC. Damn, today there's so many like games where we like have a big lead, but then we just start throwing. Pretty easy to avoid. I just took a directional lead. But I have been occasionally part of the problem, going overzealous, diving next turret, stuff like that. That seems to be the theme. Once you're like winning and you like entered this zone, starts to get scary. Got Void Staff and a Blue Pot. Two for one. Where's the Zhonya's boy? We're gonna lose it. Oh, the gods! Oh, damn. Almost won that. I was trying to eat the headbutt fall of Betaman, but he got it off. And then I was in the air, so I wasn't able to get my Zhonya's off before the guy just killed me. I was spamming it. It just did not work out for me. I'm gonna go Rylai's now, I think. Yeah, we did fight them with Baron there. I still have Flash Out, which is pretty big. Initially, I was peeling there because I know our tank line can outlive theirs when they dive into us, so I was just kind of waiting, trying to get the reset on like the Blitzcrank and the Aatrox, but then our tank line died and their backline, Nilly and Lucian, were still like full health, so I didn't really have a good opening on them. If I just got that Zanya's up, though, there was almost no risk of us losing that situation. Because the Alistar would have died, and then I would have been able to come up and at least get a rotation off, if not just run around, run away. Hit an elite trap. No. 1,000 gold on Rylaz. He's got double buffs. Ow. Oh, and he ulted now? Damn. But are we still in the fight? I could have just actually backed off. I wonder if they're going to be able to close this out here. Why not? Flash, got the Alistar. I got the attention of the Anili and Lucian before I died. So, I'm assuming someone else would have died if they had been focusing them instead of me when I flashed in. But I don't think it was that bad since I got the Alistar and divert them, but maybe there's a better play. I would have to look at it, and it would only be in retrospect that it'd be obvious to me. I thought there was a chance we could clean them up, but again, the Nili and the Lucian just sit in the back, and usually are unscathed by the end of the fight. It's hard for me to go for them because no one gets them low, so unless I get the reset off someone near them, then I'm probably already going to be low from fighting inside the tank line. But yeah, I could have played that one better. Not just the ending of it, the beginning when I was looking to fight. If I never got hit by the Nili Spear though, that would have been like so clean. But I was at like 50% HP, looking for an entry point to the whole fight. And damn, we just gave them another Food Baron. Oh wait, no, they didn't get this one yet. Okay, that's good. Oh, that was an invisible spear. I hate those. Oh, wow, that guy didn't die before I came out of Shazanya's. That was so brutal. Creeps are ending. I think they're gonna win this. Bulber has a tank. Wow, I got hit by that. Life's off the ward. Base. Come on, creeps. Nice, got both next turrets. It's gonna give me enough for Rylaz as well, which is really useful versus their team. Lucian got his back off. He's leading us on a goose chase. Yeah, they should have 3-man Baron while that whole thing happened. I should have called that. But I'll get Leandri as my last item, and then I'll be pretty much done with upgrades. Damn, that Blitz slid with, like, barely any health. He died right as I came out. If I had my Shumpo up there, I could have Shumpoed away from them and survived, but got no reset until, like, slightly after my Zanya's faded. Wow, it's coming up. It's gonna be so annoying. Whatever. Fine. Good game. Yeah, I think that's the right call. The timeline they didn't hit was annoying, because I could have ended the game if they had like lost the team fight at Baron, but what I ended up having was they sent the Lucian back, so he wasn't part of the team fight, and then my team won like the 4v4 pretty hard, because Lucian is a huge damage source, like pretty much their only damage source, to be honest, that's reliable on their team. And then it just like soloed him, and my team had already won the team fight, we got Baron, just like closed the game out.